explain for this guy.
Where is this guy?
You gotta catch a plane tonight?
I gotta go to Hong Kong. This guy's not here yet.
Always waiting for the star, Ming Sing Tai.
Sorry. Welcome everybody to a very, very special episode of Fung Bros Food. Today we've assembled an all-star cast for a very special Cantonese seafood dinner. One very cool thing to note today is that everybody here at this dinner is of Cantonese background, with the exception of Richie, but you know, he's cool.
I'm not, but sambei bing sui.
I got three ice waters on the way.
Hi, I'm Stacy Chung. My Chinese name is Zheng Menyan.
Stacy, you were in Chinese beauty pageants.
Just one, Miss LA Chinatown.
Wes, you are the highest profile Cantonese American.
No.
I want to say in America.
No.
Who is?
Who
is it?
You and Jin.
Jin's got
no, but you
so
and Jin.
More.
No, I mean, thank you, Wes, for being here.
How can I turn this down? This is awesome.
So I'm Christy, and I am a food blogger. I write and I eat for a living, and I eat out to 3 or 4 different restaurants a day.
I grew up really near LA Chinatown, so I'm here to represent Cantonese experience as legit as it can get from there.
He's here to represent the Cantonese Chinatown experience. Holla!
Thank you! Seafood dinners is such a big part of being Cantonese.
And I think it's because Cantonese are right next to the water.
It's a port city, so they've had like a lot of connections with other people, so they've got all types of import and export of various species of sea critters.
We have a geoduck done two ways. So this is a sashimi style, which you're gonna use with wasabi sauce. And then the second way is they take the rest of it and then deep fry it with salt and pepper.
Gooey ducks look actually really funny.
Would you call them gooey ducks?
Are they called gooey ducks?
Geoducks.
So I've been calling it a gooey duck this whole time.
What are you saying? We're eating a Pokemon?
Yeah. I heard gooey ducks my whole life.
No, you know what it is? We're from Seattle and you can just find gooey ducks like on the water.
I can't take you seriously when you say gooey ducks.
Hold up, see,
local
so
slang.
We're from
local
where
slang.
They come from, so we know we can call them a different name.
Okay, alright.
So what's up with the wasabi? I feel like wasabi is a Japanese thing.
That's what I was gonna, I've never had it like this.
This is a fusion dish they have here, so they take some traditional like geoduck and they do it sashimi style because you know, Chinese people love Japanese food as well, so they make it like sashimi. It's actually really good.
I ain't gonna lie, it's like a really firm clam.
Yep.
It's like a really firm, big, raw clam.
Yeah.
The fried version is basically the opposite of the sashimi version.
Let's take a look at these gigantic alien prawns.
Live shrimp, you can see all the eggs on the bottom too.
Yo, every one of those shrimps has eggs at the bottom?
Alright, straight up, I think it's pretty crazy, and this is a testament to how fresh Cantonese seafood is that we're eating the shrimp with the roe still inside. I'm not gonna say that this shrimp was in the middle of giving birth, or, you know, trying to do its reproductive thing. We caught it at an awkward moment.
And you're really Cantonese if you know how to eat the head, too.
Oh.
Everyone, let's gumboy with the heads.
Hey! Tell us about this dish. Christy.
Taohim, so there's a lot of bell peppers, onions. This is the most typical version you see in Cantonese restaurants.
Gumsalam gua tiu. Ding 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 ding!
I've never seen this before.
This is actually a special dress up New Lucky. So they take the lao sa bao, which is really sand dim sum, the duck yolk that comes out of it, and they fry it on top of the pumpkin strips.
That's fancy. Duck yolk.
Man, the way Christy talks about that food.
Sit next to me. Are you a food blogger or something?
Not very creamy.
Because the pumpkin's really soft and actually sweet itself, and then you hit it with the duck yolk.
What is the best way you know to serve this fish?
The way I remember eating this is my mom would be like, oh, I'm a whole night. And she would like, you know, get some fish for me. And I know it, just that. Like, Wow.
Even the tone, you take it. The way you told the story,
dude,
it was like, get the fish.
Was that a movie? Is that a short? That's a new short.
Stacy, you were in the Chinatown pageant world. How would you serve this fish?
Yes, our fish serving skills was probably 80% of the competition. You can use the second spoon so that you can try to lift up the bone part, and that's how you dig out the meat from the bottom without the
So what she's doing, instead of pulling it all off, the whole skeleton, she's actually just sneaking under the rug and just grabbing what's under the couch.
And you know what? That's the best part of the meat because it's already all soaked in the soy sauce.
Wow!
When people think of Chinese food, they think of Cantonese food. Now, they don't necessarily think of this because this is a little bit more advanced. I think they're talking about the chow mians, the chow funs. One Tons,
aka Panda Express,
Ba Fan, which is white rice.
I would just put that on rice.
Yes, yes.
And just eat it straight. Just,
yeah.
I feel like after watching a lot of like Chinese cartoons, it was always like this. The kid goes, ah.
Long Ha Yi Min.
What do they got me saying over here?
I think there's so much pressure for them to give you gigantic prawn-like shrimps, and they just kept it small, but then the flavor was really strong.
In my opinion, and I've eaten a lot of different types of food, I think Cantonese people do vegetables the best. It's not to say that other people don't have good vegetables. Stir frying is the strength of the Cantonese cuisine as far as vegetables go.
What I love about when a crab is fried, you can just eat everything, like the little shells inside, maybe not the top shell, but the little shells inside, it's just like crispy to me.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Get the fried garlic with the peppers. Yo, I would eat this just on rice.
You only know how to eat crab the way they teach you in like Western restaurants, but this is a completely different way to do it. You don't even really need the cracker tool. Last but not least, we have the Tsu-yim-ha.
This is a quality fried shrimp dish. They also have this dish at the buffet, but it's never gonna come like this. You got the fresh, finely chopped chives and onions on top, and then you got the jalapenos, along with it being fried with salt and pepper. And the best thing about this, you can literally just eat the whole thing.
Oh my god.
Salt and pepper everything.
Oh.
Food is really important in Chinese culture, and that's apparent just by, we don't say how are you when you greet someone, you say, which is have you eaten yet?
So it's been 7 years, I've lived here in LA, and this is my first time actually eating a Cantonese seafood dinner with some really good friends. You guys should try it. I think I'm gonna do this again. You guys wanna go again?
Let's do it, yeah? Let's do it tomorrow.
Well, this is what I call a family style dinner.
Nice! Hey. I like that one.
That was the pageant.
When the white fungus, sweet super rice, that signifies the end of the meal.
This was a very special episode of Fung Bros Food, like I said. I'm just glad we all got to come here. We got to talk about a food that is very dear to all of us, and it's really good. So shout out to New Lucky Restaurant on Garvey and Monterey Park.
Till next time on Fung Brothers Food, peace.
Soy-kin.
Thank you for watching that video. Please subscribe to our channel. Shout out to Wes, Christy, Jamie, Stacy for coming out. Shout out to Richie. Shout out to New Lucky Restaurant in Monterey Park. Watch this video here. Watch this over here. This is another one. We'll put it right here.
That one's good. Check that one out. Fung Bros Comedy.
And check out Wong Fu too.
He said that really.
Wong Fu too.
And shout out Christy's blog. Christy's food blog. We'll put another thing here somewhere. Anyways. Rich's channel, peace!
Talking.